Welcome to our fifth Sunday of Easter and Mother's Day service at Greenwood United Methodist Church in Greenwood, Florida, via YouTube. Our purpose today is twofold. The first and foremost, to honor the Lord Jesus Christ on this fifth Sunday of Easter with everything we say and with everything we do. Second, to honor our mothers, our grandmothers, and our great grandmothers. Let us pray. On this special day set aside to honor mothers, Lord, we ask for your special touch for each and every mother. May each mother be granted a special blessing, and may all of the work of their hands not be forgotten in your sight. Let her example to her children be a guiding force in their lives. And may wisdom be passed down to the next generation of mothers. Amen. Today's message is going to come from Psalms 127, verses 1 through 25. Psalms 127, verses 1 through 5. And scripture states, "Except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waketh, but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. Lo, children are an inheritance from the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is the reward. As sorrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are the children of the youth. Happy is the man that has his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate." This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. Today, my message is titled, Honoring Christian Mothers. Honoring Christian Mothers. Let's get into the message. Today, my message goal is to honor Christian mothers around the world. We have many reasons we should honor them for their sacrificial and unselfish love. They have given us all the loving deeds they have done for us throughout our lives, for all the prayers they have prayed for us, and for all the sleepless nights they have spent for us with tears running down their cheeks. Mothers may not work behind a big office desk with a view overlooking the North Bay like I have at work, but there is no job more important than that of a Christian mother. Their job is often demanding and often unrewarding. With this message, I would like for us to look at four special characteristics of a Christian mother, and how these traits have an effect upon those under her care. The first characteristic of a Christian mother is joy. Many people think that joy and happiness are the same, but they are not. Joy comes from having a right relationship with God, our eternal creator. When things are right between us and God, we can experience the joy that comes from the Lord. You see, happiness is the feeling we feel when things in our realm of life are going well for us. That's happiness. But you see, joy is not easily lost because our relationship with God does not change just because the conditions or circumstances change, or at least it should not. Even when we are in the valley, we have the full assurance that God loves us and that we are God's children. Regardless of what is taking place, God is at work in our lives, working all things together for our good. God is always in total control of things, and he is all wise, all knowing, and all powerful. God is always on our side, desiring the very best for us. There is nothing that we can do that will cause God to stop loving us. God may not love the things that we do sometimes, but he always will be found to love us. Therefore, no child of God should ever allow Satan to rob them of their joy. Satan does not have that power to take joy from anyone. The only way you can lose your joy is to give it away. And looking at the joy of a Christian mother, joy is the greatest gift she could possibly give to her family. It is such a blessing from above to have a joyful mother who, regardless of the difficulties of everyday life, she continues to go about her business with a joyful spirit, always uplifting and encouraging those within her care. Christian mothers can always seem to see the good times are just around the corner. And they keep on encouraging their children to continue to look up to God, who is the source of their strength in weary times. To all Christian mothers, as stated best in Philippians chapter 4, verse 4, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. And then in Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. Thank God for joyous Christian mothers. How many times will we have stopped trusting our Christian mother without telling us, child, a better day is coming. Just keep on trying. I love you, and God loves you. The second characteristic of a Christian mother is peace. Too many people today are looking for peace, but do not know where to begin to find it. Peace does not mean that everything is perfect in our lives. Peace comes when we know that all things are under control. However, to know true peace, we have to know God. As humans, we can never truly say that everything is under control, because we are weak creatures. We do not know what will happen next. We may hammer down all the boards and turn around and the nail has popped up somewhere. It seems like we spend too much of our life nailing down boards that keep popping up. Yet our God is not weak. Our God is not frail as we are. God really does have all things under his control, even COVID-19. You see, nothing catches God off guard. God is always prepared for everything. To know peace, we have to place all of our faith and all of our trust in God. In John chapter 14, verse 27, Jesus said, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. And further, as written in Philippians chapter 4, verse 7, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. You see, a Christian mother who knows personally the peace of God abiding in her heart can keep her home a place of peace, can keep her home a place of serenity. Because we all know a peaceful home is a wonderful place to return to after a hard day of being out in the world that is full, a world full of havoc. The third characteristic of a Christian mother is thankfulness. You know, we are often guilty of looking at the bad rather than looking at the good, the negative instead of the positive. We tend to mumble rather than express our thankfulness. But as Christians, we are encouraged to think in ways that are edifying, think in ways that are uplifting. When we do this, we will have a good attitude regardless of what is going on in our lives. As stated in Philippians chapter 4, verse 8, whatsoever things are of a good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. You know, Paul wrote those words while being confined in prison. You see, Paul's circumstances did not hinder his view of his blessings. Thankfulness is a matter of being in control inside our mind, inside our thoughts, and keeping them from being a pile of things that we are blessed with. There's so much that we can fill our minds with because of God's constant blessings. But you know, when we allow our minds to wander over into the negative realm, we begin to focus upon all the wrong things taking the place, whether with us or with others. We get discouraged and depressed, and it's hard to climb out of that bottomless pit. But however, a Christian mother will focus upon the good things they have to enjoy. Christian mothers guide their children into thankfulness by being thankful themselves. They focus upon the good things in their children, but they do not totally ignore the bad things in their children. You know, we all have areas that are weak. We all have areas that need work, but when a Christian mother keeps reminding her children of their good qualities, it gives them the courage to deal with the areas that they need working on. The way a Christian mother looks at life goes a long way in how her children will face life when they are adults. Thank God for Christian mothers who are truly thankful for what they have rather than complaining about the things that they do not have. Now, the fourth and final characteristic of a Christian mother is dependence upon Almighty God. You see, dependency is an attitude that leans upon the strength, the wisdom, and the realization that we cannot survive without the help of someone or something mightier than we are. Here, specifically, we are referred to God being that source of strength. You see, in our society today, many mothers have focused upon their own careers with the attitude, I am woman and I can do anything. It is good for mothers to be strong and to have self-confidence, don't get me wrong. But the Christian mother realizes that regardless of her strength, she would be nowhere without God to lean on. And I can recall my own mother reminding me every day where our blessings came from. We were a poor family in rural Northwest Florida. My mom and my father, they both worked for a state mental hospital. My father was a helper in the kitchen, and my mom was a certified nursing assistant. We did not have a lot of things that other families had. And there were many, many, many lean days. But my mother, my Christian mother, always encouraged me that God would never leave us nor forsake us, that God would always meet our needs. My mom, I know my mom shed many tears for her children to have a better life than she did. But throughout her life, my mom came to the realization that God is our refuge and strength and a very present help in times of need. In fact, my mom's prayer for me never stopped, even into adulthood. For example, 5 or so years ago, a few years before my mom passed, I had some tough times after my second divorce. I was afraid and fearful. I recall telling my mom about my troubles. My mom kept encouraging me to pray and to talk to Jesus Christ. My Christian mother kept telling me that Jesus loves and cares for me. My Christian mother whispered to me, "Yes, Irvin, Jesus loves you. Yes, Irvin, Jesus loves you. For the Bible tells me so." And you know, in a day or so, I was back to par. I collected myself, but one thing I know, I didn't do it by myself. I had a Christian mother who prayed for me. I had a Christian mother who kept assuring me to depend upon God for my healing. And ever since then, I've had to depend on God hundreds and hundreds of times. But it was my Christian mother that taught me first how to trust and who to trust in. Thank God for blessing me and many others with a Christian mother who has all four of those characteristics. Let us pray. Gracious Father, maker of this world, continue to bless our Christian mothers as they go about their journey. Be with them on every road. Be with them on every hill, meadow, and stream. Be with them under clouds, under the stars, and be with them through the storms of life and in the sunshine of life. Guard them, O Father. Protect them, O Christ. Guide them, O Holy Spirit, now and in weariness, now and in happiness, now and in danger, now and in their journey's end. Enfold them in your love and surround them with your care, that they may keep praising your name in everything they do, in the care of their family, in every step, and in every way, precious Father God. Amen. Just perhaps my message touched someone in a special way. In a way so special that if you now want to give your life to Christ, then repeat this message with me, and I assure you, you will be saved. You just have to simply declare with your mouth, "Jesus Christ is Lord." And then believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. You will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified. And it is with your mouth that you confess your faith. And I assure you that you will be saved. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, amen. If you have made this decision today, we rejoice with you and we share in your excitement about your decision to accept Jesus Christ into your life. And now, as I bring this fifth Sunday of Easter and our Mother's Day message to a close, may the Lord, who brought us to birth by his Spirit, strengthen us for the Christian life. May the Lord, who provides for all our needs, sustain us day by day. And may the Lord, whose steadfast love is constant as a mother's care, send us out to live and work for others. And may the blessings of God Almighty, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.